Hey y'all, welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to paint another boat, and I actually painted this boat twice. This picture you're looking at right now is the one that I recorded, and it is a smaller 11 by 14 study of the larger picture that I painted, and this one is the full sheet, the final version, and I just wanted to familiarize myself with it before I jumped in and did this full sheet because this boat is very important. It's near and dear to my heart, and I wanted to make sure that I was familiar with it, and everything went perfect because it was a very important piece. And we will get into that in a moment, but I will tell you a little bit about the painting first. So the colors that I used for this painting are cerulean blue deep, phthalo blue, pyrrole red, and quinacridone gold. And I just found that that was all that I needed. The pyrrole red and the phthalo blue especially mix great and make these dark moody blues and purples, and it matched the hull of the boat perfectly. You can see that I have the boat masked out right now all the way down to the rigging, and I just felt it was easier because most of it is white and I don't really like to use gouache, but I will if I have to, and I think I did end up using a little bit in this painting and that's fine. It's just something that I don't want to lean on too much. And you can see that I masked out a few spots in the water to protect the yellow and red reflections from the blue. I just didn't want the yellow mast to turn green on me. So I prepped those areas, and that's why I chose to mask that off. Back up to the foliage. What I'm doing here is I'm pretty much just mixing my phthalo blue, my quinacridone gold, and I'm making a green, and then I'm leaning it either more blue or more yellow, and then when I want to mute the color a little bit, I'll throw in some pyrrole red. So it is primarily those three colors, and I will go back and define the rear lands just a little bit before I make it back down to the water. And I wanted to make the waves in the back right here a little bit softer, again to add that depth, and as I move forward they will become more pronounced. So the water itself is primarily a mixture of my two blues and the red, and you can see in the darker, more muted grayish waters, that's where I mixed in that pyrrole red with the phthalo blue and some cerulean here and there. And as I get into the reflections of the lands, that's when the quinacridone gold will play a part and I will green up some of those reflections. Now, by default, the water in this painting is a little bit more loose than the full sheet. The full sheet, you have a lot more space to spread out and put in those tiny details that you just can't squeeze into a smaller painting. And I see a lot of people try to paint really tight things in a really small area, and some newer painters think that it's even easier to paint something smaller, and a lot of times, especially if you have details to put in, that is not the case. You're better off painting it bigger. It is easier. It may take more time, but it's easier. And this painting was very time consuming. Not this one in particular. The study only took me a few days, but I think I spent on and off about a month painting the larger full sheet because it is 22 by 30. And I mean, that's the secret to painting something so detailed like this, is it just takes time. And I mean, don't get me wrong, I wasn't working on it for 8 hours a day. I'd work on it a few hours here, a few hours there, skip a few days and come back. But it just takes time and it takes patience to put those things where they need to go. Because there, like I said, there's no magic trick and there is no secret to painting realistic water or anything realistic for that matter. If you want it photorealistic, you have to put in the time. So let's talk about this boat for a minute. I originally received a commission request from a friend who is a veteran, and he wanted me to paint this boat and sent me this beautiful picture, which is the reference picture in the top left that he took. And this boat, it's named the Hot Ruddered Bum, and it definitely has a deeper meaning than I ever could have imagined when I agreed to actually take the commission. It is from Healing Towers in Ketchikan, Alaska. Mm-hmm. And this boat and the volunteers who run the program bring wounded warriors out on week-long fishing excursions of a lifetime, and they help them pretty much just reconnect with nature, and they actually help them, you know, come home, not just physically, but mentally come home. And my friend actually got a chance to befriend the founder, who is also a Vietnam veteran. His name is Mr. Gary Morfitt. And my friend wanted to repay his gratitude for the fishing trip that he received that helped him come home. And so he commissioned this piece for the founder of the program. Now, Mr. Gary has already received the completed piece, and I heard that he loves it. So that just makes me very happy that I could be a small part of showing someone's gratitude back to this man who has given so much to the veteran community. Healing Towers also works in conjunction with a nonprofit called Project Healing Waters. Healing Waters takes wounded warriors out of hospital settings or just daily life, and it brings them back to nature by teaching them how to fly fish and how to make their own flies. And let me tell you, if you think for one second that their mission is not impactful, I urge you to go to healingtowers.org and watch the video at the top of the screen. It wasn't until I viewed it that I realized exactly what this organization did, as well as the Ketchikan community, and what they give back to my fellow veterans. Moved is an understatement about how I felt when I watched that video. So I would like to thank Mr. Gary and Project Healing Waters for all that they do. And I would also like to thank Mr. Gary for his service, because he is a veteran himself. If you are a veteran and you are interested in this program and what they provide, just know that there are several of them spread across the country, and chances are there's probably one locally near you. If you're interested in donating to this program, I will also leave their web address in the description below. They are a 501c3 nonprofit organization, so that just means that there are checks and balances, and you know for a fact that your money is going to what you donated it for and these awesome veterans. And I guess now I'm just about done with painting, and I talked through most of it, but this organization was so very important for me to share with you, so I had to take the opportunity. And you can see the finished piece right here, and the next photo will be both of them side by side, the larger sheet underneath. I hope you guys liked today's video. If you did, give it a thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't already. Check out my social media accounts. I am on Facebook and Instagram, and I will see you guys next time. Bye.